So we're looking at the lean-to roof detail here. Okay, it's usually attached to the gable end of a house. Okay, so we have our concrete eaves detail here, a standard 350 wall, 100mm insulation, wall plate sitting on the inner leaf, joists, and we're going to put a 30 degree pitch in this. Okay, so then when it comes up at 30 degrees to hit our gable end wall here, we have a wall plate, a nail plate attached to the wall, here to carry the rafter, and here to carry the joist. Okay, so you can see in between the joists are insulated, and we have same detail with the slates, three starter slates, and up at our flashing area. This is the most important bit here. So our felt goes on first. Okay, you can let it on up the wall. Okay, then you put on a stepped DPC, okay, which comes down over the felt and across at our block level here, and then it's stepped up one height of 215, the height of a block, onto our inner leaf here. Okay, so that's to make sure that no moisture comes in and it won't travel up or won't travel straight across. Okay, so that, and then we put in some lead flashing as well. Okay, so that's to waterproof it, this detail here. So we can get cracking on this. Okay. Eaves detail over here, 100-150mm cavity. Okay, 21.5, 1mm for mortar, 21.5 and 1mm. 21.5. Okay, I'm gonna put on my 75mm wall plate. And where my block work. Okay, so I'm going to leave off the outside block here for eaves of the roof, okay, for the eaves of the rafter. So I'm going to get my 30 degree line there, okay, perpendicular line. I'm going to come down 5mm and up 10, 150mm rafter, okay, that's to accommodate for my bird's mouth. Okay, so I have my seed coat and my prim cut. Right, so I'll be fitting soffit batten on here. Okay, and just blow the soffit batten. Come on out until you hit your 30 degree line here. Okay, that will give us plumb cut, C-cut. Okay, so I can put in my 12mm soffit, which is going to have a vent in it here. fishing word. 25 minute fishing word. Okay, so inner leaf, need 100 mil cavity or 100 mil insulation. Then on up there. And don't forget your water. Okay. Water there. Now, so we're going to have a vent in our rafter here. Okay, so from the edge of the block there, put it in pink to 3 mil. By 70. There's our vent. Okay, so to the inside leaf over here. Up the line from my inside leaf and bring it across my black work here. Okay. So it's 100, 150 cavity, and 100. Insulation. Okay. Now, so we have our rafters sitting up here, so it's going to be hitting the wall plate here, 50 mil wall plate. Okay, and that's 150 mil. Okay, can also bring you across a joist that's sitting on our wall plate over here. Okay, yeah, and the height of that joist is 150 mil. That's also sitting onto a 50 mil wall plate. Which also has a batten fixed onto it. 50 mil batten fixed on to our wall plate here. So we'll have to notch the joists. it just gives a bit more strength to our joist, or not your joist, and it sits on our batten like so. Okay, so that's the detail of our joists there. So the next step we're looking at is we can insulate our joists here. Okay, so we've an insulator there, and then we're going to put on our cavity barrier. So we have our air vent here, allowing airflow up into our attic space. Okay, so I can do the black work. Blackwork and just our insulation. That's our insulation, and going to put in a few wires. Just a block. Okay. Now, so we'll put on my felt next to one. Here. Yeah. going along the top of the rafter. Okay. I'm going to fill it there to give it a bit of an upstand. Okay, so the felt doesn't sag. It's obviously very good here. Okay, so that is our felt. Now we want to put in our stepped DPC. Yeah. So it comes across our black work here. Comes down over our felt. Go down the roof like so. Up across the cavity and into our black work here. Okay. So that's our step DPC. Okay, we have our lead flashing. Goes on when after the slates. You have your lead fixed to the wall here, a lead apron. That's your step DPC. Okay, it comes down over your felt. It's a light blue line there, across our outer leaf, up the cavity, and across at our inner leaf. And that's just lead flashing that's nailed on before the plasterer comes along and plasters over it. Okay. So, some battens. So, 1 centimeter, 15 to 5, 15 to 5, 20 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 to 5, Okay, so we have our batten plan, so we can go slating. Okay, half slate. So 600 mil slate. Yeah, so it starts halfway in the batten. Dot six. Six. So if the last year only leave a 250 mil overhang, so we're gonna have to cut a few slats. Okay, mark off 25. That's our last cut slate then. Okay, so that's our slate now. Now so with the lead flashing, okay, the lead apron is here already. Okay. So the plaster comes along and has plastered on top of that. Okay, so what you need to do then, you turn up this lead flashing and we put the lead flashing underneath it. Okay, it sits down on top of the roof here. Then treat it. Okay, so attach it over the step DPC and over our felt. It sits down on top of our slate here. And then this is folded back down over flashing. And that is our detail there, weatherproof. Okay, that is our lean-to drawn detail finished. Okay. You can roll out extra insulation then on top of your joists if needs be. So, one or two things I'm still missing. I'm just looking at there. I have scrim, okay, for here. And plasterboard underneath trusses and internal render. Plaster here and internal plaster here. That is lean-to roof finished.